सदाशिवसमारंभं शंकराचार्यमध्यमस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तं वन्दे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ब्रह्माणविजातिपूर्ववेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। नाम्नायान्ते संसिद्धमाधिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। So we begin with the third pada of the second adhyaya. Here the vritti says, the tritiyah pada, purvasmin pade shruti viruddhatvat parapakshanam anapekshatvam abhani. What was done earlier, in the earlier pada, purvasmin pade, shruti virodha was shown. And due to the virodha with the shruti of the other pakshas, parapaksha, parapakshanam, anapekshatvam abhani. Therefore, there is anapeksha. The independent analysis and swakapola kalpita or some hypothesis that is made as a darshana without any basis in shruti may still seem logical, but if at all it has virodha with shruti, then it should be set aside. So this is what was abhani, it was stated. Now what is being done is that tarhi shruti naam api anyonya viruddhatvat. If you set aside our darshanas because there is virodha with shruti, then in the shruti itself there are so many vakyas which have mutual contradiction. Sentences are mutually contradictory with each other, says the Purvapakshi. Tarhi shrutinam api anyonya viruddhatvat brahma karanavadasya api anapekshatvam syat iti shanka nirasartham param padadvayam arabhyate. The next two padas, meaning this tritiya and the chaturtha pada, basically whatever remains in the second chapter now, what is it going to deal with is that it is going to refute or resolve the doubt. What kind of a doubt? Shanka nirasartham. The purpose of the two padas to begin the third and the fourth pada is to resolve the doubts which come up looking at the apparent contradiction in the shruti vakyas, among the shruti vakyas. Mutually there is contradiction. Shruti naam api anyonya viruddhatvat. Prima facie, when you look at it and take literal meaning without any bhashya ityadi to resolve the doubts, then what happens is that one thinks that there is virodha. And this virodha specifically towards brahma being karana. So brahma karana vadasya api anapekshatvam. This brahma karana vada also has to be set aside. This is the doubt. The next two padas are going to resolve these kind of objections and doubts. Evanja purvapadena asya padadvayasya drishtanta sangatihi shanka vyajena darshita. So through the resolution of the shanka, what is being shown is that there is a sangati. What kind of sangati? Drishtanta sangati. The example with the purvapada and the next two padas. The next two padas have a sangati with the earlier second pada as to drishtanta sangati, because it should be, the second pada is being used as an example, or it should be used as an example as per the Purvapakshi, and taking the same methodology of setting aside whatever has virodha with the shruti, you have to set aside the shruti itself, one of the two shrutis. If there is a virodha between two shrutis, one shruti at least should be set aside, or both. Virodha has to be dealt with within the shruti in the same manner the way you have dealt with our darshana says the purvapakshi padantaratvat purvadikaranena asya adhikaranasya na sangati apeksha. So what is the sangati between the earlier adhikarana and this adhikarana? The vritti says bhagwan vritti sorry, I'm sorry, I'm a little sleepy. So भगवान सदाशिवेन्द्र सरस्वती ब्रह्मेन्द्र सरस्वती. सो सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र ट्राइंग टू बिकॉज मल्टीपल नेम्स आर देर वेरी वेल नोन एज सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र. सो भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र बिकॉज आई बीन सेइंग वृत्तिकारा एट टाइम्स बट वृत्तिकारा इज अ नेम विच इज हेल्ड फॉर अ पूर्व पक्षी हु इज अ वेदांतिन बट इज एन एकदेशी. द एकदेशी वाद आई विल कम अप हियर. Therefore, this Vrittikara may not be appropriate. Therefore, I am trying to put a samskara of, you know, Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra. So, what he says is that because this is a different pada, Adhikarana, two Adhikaranas, meaning the last Adhikarana in the second pada and the first Adhikarana in the Tritiya pada need not have any Sangati. So, what is the Adhikarana here? First Adhikarana is Vyad Adhikaranam. So, Vyad is Akasha. Dealing with Akasha, Akasha Utpatti. Virodha is being shown in Shruti as to some places in Taittiriya Upanishad, the Akasha Utpatti has been mentioned. Whereas in Chandogya Upanishad, Shashto Adhyaya, Akasha Utpatti has not been mentioned. Similarly, Vayu Utpatti has not been mentioned, which will be the next Adhikarana. And what is the Mahabhuta which comes up first, that is Tejas. Agni Utpatti has been mentioned in the Chandogya Upanishad as being born from Brahma. Whereas your Taittiriya Upanishad says Akasha is born from Brahma. Therefore, this Akasha Utpatti and Akasha Arutpatti in another Upanishad are opposed to each other. This is the Purva Paksha. न वियद अश्रुते हे न वियद अश्रुते हे. सो एकदेशी मता, दिस इज एन एकदेशी मता, हु इज वेदांतिन. फर्स्ट ही रिफ्यूट्स द पूर्व पक्ष. व्हाट इज द पूर्व पक्ष? अत्र पूर्व पक्षे श्रुतीनां मिथो विरोधात् अप्रामाण्यम्. यू हैव टू लुक एट द वृत्ति बिकॉज इन द इंट्रोडक्शन द पूर्व पक्ष हैज नॉट बीन गिवन एंड दिस इज अ एकदेशी सिद्धांत सूत्र. इट इज नॉट परम सिद्धांत, इट इज एकदेशी. वेदांति इज रिफ्यूटिंग बाय न वियद अश्रुते हे. सो अत्र पूर्वपक्षी श्रुतीनां मिथो विरोधात् अप्रामाण्यम्. पूर्वपक्षी सेइंग बिकॉज ऑफ विरोध. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ विरोध? म्यूचुअल विरोध. श्रुतीज हैव म्यूचुअल opposition with each other, contradiction with each other, and therefore there is no pramanyam. It is not a pramana. Shruti is not a pramana in this particular area at least. And Siddhanti says Siddhanti virodha bhavat pramanyam iti phalaveda. Siddhanti says that there is no virodha and therefore Shruti nam pramanyam. Shrutis are valid pramana. So what is this sutra itself? पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग दैट आकाश उत्पत्ति एंड वायु उत्पत्ति और आकाश अनुत्पत्ति. आकाश उत्पत्ति एट वन प्लेस एंड आकाश उत्पत्ति नॉट बीइंग मेंशन्ड एट अनदर प्लेस, देयर इज अ विरोध. सो द एकदेशी इज सेइंग इन द सूत्र. सो वी विल फिनिश द सूत्र बिकॉज वी हैव टू गो मच फर्दर इन द वृत्ति टू अंडरस्टैंड द पूर्वपक्ष. सो द एकदेशी सिद्धांत इज सेइंग न वियत अश्रुते, मीनिंग वियदः और रादर वियत न उत्पद्यते. वी कैन से वियत न उत्पद्यते. व्हाय? अश्रुते हे, बिकॉज श्रुति इज नॉट देयर. टू काउंटर द पूर्व पक्षी, सी इन फैक्ट वियद उत्पत्ति इज देयर वन एट वन प्लेस एंड समवेयर इट इज नॉट देयर, सेज द पूर्व पक्षी. The Ekadeshi Siddhanti is saying no, Viyat Utpatti, Akasha Utpatti is not there. Akasha does not कम फ्रॉम ब्रह्म. सो दी पूर्वपक्षी डेफिनेटली इज गोइंग टू कोट तैतिरीय उपनिषद वेर इट इज मेंशन दैट आकाश उत्पत्ति इज देयर. सो हाउ दैट इज काउंटर्ड वील सी लेटर इन दी वृत्ति. बट दी पूर्वपक्षी इज answered by the Ekadeshi Siddhanti as to Vyat Utpatti is not there. So Vyat na Utpadyate. Why? Ashrute. There is no such Shruti. To that the Purvapakshi will give a Shruti, but right now Shruti is not there, says the Ekadeshi Siddhanti. Ekadeshi Vedanti. So Atra Purvapakshi Shruti na Mitho Virodat Apramanyam Siddhanti Virodabhavat Pramanyam iti Phalaveda. एवं सर्वेषु च अधिकरणेषु पादद्वय गतेषु पूर्वोत्तर पक्षयो फलं द्रष्टव्यम्. सो सर्वेषु च अधिकरणेषु इन दिस मैनर द फल हैज टू बी सीन इन दी इन ऑल दी अधिकरणास अक्रॉस दी रिमेनिंग टू पादास थर्ड एंड दी फोर्थ पाद ऑफ दी सेकंड चैप्टर एज टू व्हाट इज दी ऑब्जेक्शन ऑफ दी पूर्व पक्षी एंड व्हाट इज ही एक्सपेक्टिंग एज अ फल. दिस इज हाउ दी पूर्व एंड दी उत्तर पक्ष ऑल्सो हेज टू बी सीन मीनिंग उत्तर पक्ष मीनिंग सिद्धांत. अत्र आदौ सृष्टिवाक्यानां अविरोधं प्रतिपादयितुं आकाशम आश्रित्य विचार्यते. सो दिस विरोध अक्रॉस दी श्रुतीज इज बीइंग डेल्ट विथ अक्रॉस ऑल दी अधिकरणास अक्रॉस बोथ दी पादास विच आर रिमेनिंग. हाउएवर इनिशियली व्हाट इज बीइंग डन आकाश इज टेकन एज एन एग्जाम्पल टू बिगिन विथ. वेर इज दिस विरोध? ओ वील शो यू लॉट ऑफ विरोधास अमाउंट श्रुति सेज दी पूर्व पक्षी. लेट स्टार्ट विद आकाश. सो आदौ अत्र सृष्टिवाक्यानां अविरोधं प्रतिपादयितुं सिद्धांति सेज यू कीप ऑन शोइंग मी विरोध. आई विल आंसर इट एंड कीप ऑन शोइंग यू अविरोध. सो सृष्टिवाक्यानां अविरोधं इन दी सृष्टिवाक्य देर इज विरोध सेज पूर्व पक्षी एंड सिद्धांति सेज आल शो देर इज नो विरोध. And to do that, Akasha Mashritya, taking Akasha as the example, Vicharyate. Kim Akashasya Utpattir Asti Uta Neti Sandehe Yadyasti Tarhi Chandogye Akasha Vayu Vina Tat Tejo Srujata Iti Teja Adhika Srishtishruyate. Whether Akasha is born or Akasha is not born, whether Akasha is created or it is not created, when such Sandhaya is there, that time there is an analysis. What is the analysis? Yadi asti, yadi Akashasya utpatti asti, vyadaha utpatti Akashasya utpatti asti tarhi. If Akasha is created, then in Chandogya Akasha Vayu vina, without Akasha and Vayu, this is Akasha and Vayu Dvivachana. आकाश वायु विना तत् तेजो सृजत. तत् इज ब्रह्म सद्ब्रह्म. तत् सद्ब्रह्म तेजो सृजत क्रिएटेड तेज. तेज इज अग्नि. सो विदाउट आकाश एंड वायु इट्सेल्फ ब्रह्म परमात्मा हैज क्रिएटेड व्हाट तेजस अग्नि. सो इति तेज आदि का सृष्टि ही श्रूयते. तेज आदि का मीन्स तेज देन जलम देन पृथ्वी. तेजोपन्नम इन छांदोग्य शब्द तेज अप. अप इज जलम एंड अन्नम. अन्नम इज पृथ्वी. सो दीज थ्री एलिमेंट्स हैव बीन क्रिएटेड. दैट इज द प्रोसेस बिगिनिंग विथ व्हाट? बिगिनिंग विथ अग्नि तेजस इन छांदोग्य सिक्स चैप्टर. तैत्तिरीय केतु हवेर इन तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद व्हाट इज द केस? आत्मना आकाश संभूत. सो तस्माद्वा एतस्माद् आत्मनः आकाश संभूतः इति आकाशादि का सृष्टि श्रूयते. यू शुड ब्रिंग सृष्टि श्रूयते. सो वेर एज इन दी तैतिरीय उपनिषद सृष्टि है द क्रिएशन ऑफ व्हाट? आकाश इज हर्ड बिकॉज आत्मना आकाश संभूत. वेर एज इन छांदोग्य आकाश वायु विना तेजस सृष्टि इज देर इन छांदोग्य इन without Akasha and Vayu. And in Taittiriya Upanishad, what is there? Atmana Akasha Sambhutaha Akashat Vayuhu. So Akasha Vayu Shrishti both are mentioned there. Okay, the rain is too loud for me. Let me plug in the earphones. Give me a moment. सॉरी, एम आई स्टिल ऑडिबल? तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद आकाशाद वायु इज ऑल्सो हर्ड, देयरफॉर देयर इज कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन ऑन फेस वैल्यू. डेफिनेटली देयर कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन, यू कैनॉट गेट अवे बाय सेइंग दैट नो देयर इज नो कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन. अविरोधम, जस्ट बाय सेइंग अविरोधा यू कैनॉट गेट अवे, यू टू एक्सप्लेन हाउ देर इज अविरोधा. तथा च अनयोर वाक्योर विरोध इति पूर्वपक्ष, देर इज डेफिनेट कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन बिटवीन द टू श्रुतिज, तैत्तिरीय एंड द छांदोग्य श्रुति. सिद्धांतस्तु, दिस सिद्धांत इज वॉट एकदेशी मतेन. एकदेशी हू एग्रीज विथ वन पार्ट ऑफ द श्रुति, नॉट एवरीथिंग एज एज इट इज. सो वॉट दे डू इज दैट दे से देर इज, मीनिंग बेसिकली वॉट इट इज, देर इज बंधा इन, generally it is seen as there is bandha in, but in baddha avastha there is prapancha and in mukti avastha there is no prapancha. So something of that sort is there, meaning one who is baddha after shravana will be released through manana and nididhyasana, but they say that there is this bandha is not completely non-existent or mithya also. So the real bandha will also, basically one who is baddha will get converted into mukta. So something of that sort is there, ekadesha deshi mata. So ekadeshi, and we have seen this ekadeshi mata in the first pada of the first adhyaya. सो एकदेशी मतेन न वियत आकाशः न वियत न उत्पद्यते, मीनिंग आकाश न उत्पद्यते, आकाश इज नॉट बॉर्न. हाउ सो? तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद सेज सो. हाउ डू यू से दैट आकाश इज नॉट बॉर्न? बिकॉज देर इज अ श्रुति आत्मनः आकाश संभूतः. सो कस्मात् अश्रुतेः, अश्रुतेः शुड बी अंडरलाइन देर, इट इज द मूल. सो अश्रुतेः वाई? इट इज नॉट हर्ड इन द श्रुति, but it is heard, says the Purvapakshi. There the Ekadeshi will give an answer that it is Gauna. The Utpatti is not real Utpatti, it is not a Shruti which is giving primary meaning, it is a secondary meaning. So it is Gauna, there is no real Utpatti of Akasha, it is Gauna, meaning secondary. It should not be taken as the main meaning, or it should not be taken as really so. It is not a literal meaning, says the Purvapakshi. Ekadeshi Siddhanti, who is also Purvapakshi for the Parama Siddhanta. So, kasmat ashrute akashasya utpatti pratipadaka vakyasya ashravanat. There is no shravana, meaning there is no Veda vakya which is heard. Vakyasya, which vakya? Which is pratipadaka, which is a revealer of what? Utpatti of akasha. So, akashasya utpatti. There is no such shruti, says the एकदेशी सिद्धांती वेदांती. यद्यपि आत्मना आकाश संभूत इति श्रुतिरस्ति, ऑल्दो देर इज दिस यद्यपि शुड गो, देर इज दिस कोटेशन मार्क विच शुड नॉट गो हियर, इट शुड गो हियर. आत्मना आकाश संभूत इति श्रुति, यद्यपि इज आउटसाइड दैट कोटेशन. सो यद्यपि आत्मना आकाश संभूत इति श्रुतिरस्ति, यस, तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद डज से सो. सो वी हैव हर्ड इट, वी हैव ऑल हर्ड इट. हाउएवर, तथापि सा गौणी इति गूढ़ाभिसंधि. The secret is that, secret in the sense, in Vedanta you have to understand, you should not take everything literally, says the Ekadeshi. You have to understand that Shruti is Gauna. It is a Gauna Shruti. You should not take literal meaning there. It is just saying something to get to the Agni Utpatti. But it is not really so, says the Ekadeshi. And therefore there is no virodha. One is a Gauna Shruti and the other is a Mukhya Shruti. Chandogya Shruti is Mukhya Shruti and Taittiriya Shruti, which talks about Akasha and Vayu Utpatti, these are Gauna. Therefore Gauna and Mukhya cannot have virodha. Therefore there is no virodha, says the Purvapakshi, Ekadeshi, because who is Ekadeshi is also Purvapakshi. Siddhanta will be mentioned, Parama Siddhanta, a little later. ततश्च आकाशस्य उत्पत्तेः अनभ्युपगमात् एव न विरोध इति ग्रंथाभिसंधिम अजानानः शंकते. सो देर इज अ पूर्व पक्षी हु डज नॉट नो दैट इट इज अ गौण. इट इज दिस वियत उत्पत्ति आकाश उत्पत्ति इन तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद इज नॉट गौण. दिस इज द थिंकिंग ऑफ द पूर्व पक्षी. सो गूढ़ाभिसंधि विच वॉज मेन्शन दिस इज यू नो दोज हु हैव स्टडीड वेदांत प्रॉपरली सेज द एकदेशी ट्राइंग टू रिजॉल्व द apparent virodhas, they know this secret as to Akasha and Vayu are not really born. But those who do not know, who is that, this Purva Pakshi, who is Ajanana. So Ajanana means one who does not know. One who does not know what? Granthabhisandhi. So Granthabhisandhi, which is Gudhabhisandhi, which is actually a secret for the students to know, who are serious in studying Vedanta and not just chanting and trying to understand the meaning by themselves, says the Ekadeshi Siddhanti. So Ekadeshi Vedanti is saying that one who does not know, that kind of a Purvapakshi is asking, does not know this hidden meaning as to Akasha and Vayu Srishti is Gauna. Right now Akasha is Srishti, but Vayu is also going to come up. There also the same logic is going to be applied by the Ekadeshi as well as the Purvapakshi. So there is this hidden meaning which is not known, that kind of a person, ajanana shankate. What is that gudabhisandhi or granthabhisandhi? Tatascha akashasya utpattehe, which is mentioned in the Taittiriya Upanishad, tasya utpattehe anabhyupagamat. It has not been accepted in Vedanta as literal, at least in the Ekadeshi Mata. Na virodha, so tasmadeva. कारणात् विरोधः नास्ति, देयर इज नो विरोध. वन इज गौण एंड द छांदोग्य श्रुति इज मुख्य. सो शंकते, दैट काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट नो दीज आइडियाज विच आर डेल्ट इन वेदांता सेज अस्तितु अस्तितु. ही सेज डेफिनेटली देयर इज अ श्रुति अस्ति श्रुतिर अस्ति. व्हाट श्रुति? आकाशस्य उत्पत्ते श्रुति अस्तितु. Definitely it is there. Tu shabdaha pakshantara parigrahe. So this tu shabda is moola. So tu shabda pakshantara parigrahe. It is to say that in Taittiriya Shruti is there, so pakshantara, another paksha is there. You are saying that there is no utpatti mentioned in the Shruti, but another Shruti is there, so other paksha says definitely there is a Shruti. And you are a Vedantin, how can you set this Taittiriya Shruti aside? But this person who is asking this does not know that there is a Gudhabhisandhi, Granthabhisandhi. Tu shabdha pakshantara parigre, chandogi akashasya utpatya bhavyapi, sa shruti hi Taittiriya ke asti tyartha. So Purvapakshi is saying, okay, in chandogya there is no akasha utpatti mentioned, so there is no shruti is right. However, that shruti, sa shruti is there where? Taittiriya ke. In Taittiriya Upanishad it is there. अस्ति इत्यर्थ. तैतरीय के तैतरीय संबंधी शाखा संबंधी. सो इन द शाखा उपनिषद इज देयर. उपनिषद इज नॉट द ओनली पार्ट इन द शाखा. इट इज और उपनिषद इज नॉट द शाखा इटसेल्फ. उपनिषद इज पार्ट ऑफ द शाखा. सो तैतरीय का इज तद्धित ऑफ तैतरीय. तित्तरी फ्रॉम तित्तरी तैतरीय हैज कम एंड तैतरीय उपनिषद बिकॉज तैतरीय शाखा. So Taittiriyaka is Taittiriya Sambandhi Upanishad. So in that Upanishad, Taittiriyake Upanishadi asti ityartaha. Tathacha virodaha taravastha eva iti shankitur ashayaha. What is the perspective of the Purvapakshi? What is the idea? What is the statement he is trying to make? He is saying that because there is a Shruti which talks about Taittiriya Shruti, which talks about Akasha Utpatti, although Chandogya doesn't talk about it, Virodha between the Shruti, Taittiriya and the Chandogya Shruti, Taravastha, it is exactly so. So Virodha Taravastha means Sa Avastha Yasya Virodhasya Saha Virodha Taravastha. That Avastha which was there earlier, which Avastha was there? There was a contradictory avastha. So this virodha also has that similar contradictory avastha as pointed out earlier. Therefore, Taravastaha, Virodha is Taravastha, Virodha is having the same status, meaning it has not been resolved, it has not been countered, the objection still stands. Iti Shankitur Ashaya, this is the idea of the doubter, who is the Purvapakshi. Ekadeshi Swabhiprayam Prakatayati. What Ekadeshi is doing is that Ekadeshi answers. This is also third sutra, is also like first sutra. It is Ekadeshi Vedanti Sutra. He says Gaunya Sambhavat. Gaunya Sambhavat. So he says Gauni. Sashruti Gauni. Kutaha Asambhavat. Kasya Asambhavat. He says Samagri Asambhavat. Samagri is not there. To create Akasha, there is no Samagri. So Purvapakshi is saying that Akasha Utpatti is there. Ekadeshi Vedanti says there is no Utpatti of Akasha. Why? Because that Shruti that you are quoting is Gauni. Gauni Shruti. Strilinga. Shruti is Strilinga. Therefore Gauni Shruti. It is secondary. It has no primary meaning. You can take it as an Arthavada. It does not have primary meaning. Why? Asambhavat. Kasya Asambhavat? Utpatti Asambhavat. Utpatti is not possible. Why? Because Samagri is not available. There are no ingredients to create Akasha. What will Akasha be created out of? What is the Samavayi Karana? What is the Asamavayi Karana? All this have to be given. Without that, how can Akasha be created, says the Ekadeshi. Nahi Akashasya Utpatti Shrutir Mukhya, Kintu Gauni. So Akasha Shruti, Atmana Akasha Sambhuta in Taittiriya Upanishad is definitely there, but it is not Mukhya. It does not have primary meaning, it has secondary meaning. You can take it any other meaning, but literal meaning of Akasha Utpatti, meaning Arthavada. Kutaha, how so? Why should I take it as Gauni Shruti, not Mukhya Shruti, asks the Purvapakshi. Ekadeshi Vedanti says Asambhavat. Akasha Utpattav, it is impossible. What is the impossibility? Akasha Utpattav Samavayi Karanadi Samagrya Bhavat. There is no availability of Samavayi Karana Adi. Adi Padena Asamavayi Karanamapi. There is no Samavayi Karana available to create Akasha, and there is no Asamavayi Karana also. What is the Samavayi Karana? Dravyasya Samavayi Karanam Avayavaha. Parts are needed. When any dravya has to be created, they are put together with the parts, avayava. So the parts of the dravya, for example, let's say ghata has to be created, kapala dvaya, the two kapalas are needed to create the ghata. They are the avayavas, the parts of the ghata put together makes a ghata. So kapalas also talked about, you know, you split the, you see sometimes on the pot, you see two, you know, vertical lines on opposite sides. So those are where the two halves of the pot are joined together, especially in kumbhas ityadi. So you see that kind of the huge pot is created with two parts, and then they are put together. They are called as kapalas. So kapalas are avayavas of the dravya, and then those avayavas are samavayi karana. They are nitya sambandha. They cannot be separated. If you separate, then there will be no ghata. So as long as ghata is there, these kapalas are joined together, and kapala ghatayoho sambandha is samavayi karana. Samavayi sambandha, but samavayi karana. What has been put together to make the, what parts have been put together to make the ghata, that becomes the samavayi karana. So let's look at another example. The Tantu and the Pata Sanyoga. Sorry, Tantu and the Pata Sambandha. What is the Sambandha between the Tantu and the its end product, which is the cloth? Tantus are threads. So between the threads, there is Sanyoga. You are putting threads together. They are separate threads. So when separate threads are coming together, they have Sanyoga. But when they have been interweaved, then you get a cloth. That cloth will remain as long as these threads are there in together interviewed. Now these tantus which have been put together, and through them there is a cloth which has been created. Then this tantu and pata have what sambandha now? Tantu and pata have samavaya sambandha. And these avayavas, these parts of the pata, the cloth, are the threads, individual threads. So those threads cannot be separated, and they are the samavayi karana of the pata. They cannot be separated from the cloth. So there is a nitya sambandha. As long as the pata is there, so long the threads will be connected with the pata. And as long as the threads are there, other way around also, as long as the threads are present in the very same manner, the cloth will also be existent. So to make a cloth, you need threads. And what is the asamavayi karana? Avayava sanyogascha. So this sanyoga sambandha between the tantu, between the threads, is asamavayi karana for the pata. Without the sanyoga, you cannot have, between the threads, if there is no sanyoga, then you cannot have pata. Therefore, between the threads, the sanyoga sambandha which is there, that is asamavayi karana for the pata. So the tantu themselves, avayavas, the parts are samavayi karana, and sanyoga between the threads, tantus, is the asamavayi karana for the pata, cloth. What is the samavayi karana and asamavayi karana for akasha? Akasha is partless. So how can it have utpatti, says the ekadeshi Vedanti. So asambhavat is due to impossibility, because the samavayi and asamavayi karanas are missing as samagri, as ingredients to put together akasha. So akasha utpattav samavayi karanadi samagrya bhavat vibhutvena nityatvanumanacha akasha utpattir asambhavad ityartha. What is asambhava? The asambhava is explained as Samagri not being available. And why Samagri not available? Because Vibhut, Vibhupadartha, Akasha is there everywhere. Where are the parts seen? So Nityatva Anumanacha. And therefore, due to Akasha being available everywhere, having no parts, Samagri is not there. And when Avayavas are not there, Samavayi Karana cannot be there. And when Avayavas are not there, Avayas Sanyoga is not possible. So asamavayi karana is also not there. So samagri is not there. That is one reason. And due to being vibhu, there is also another anumana. That which is vibhu has to be nitya, says the nayayika. So therefore nityatva anumanacha. You can infer that akasha is nitya. And nityasya padarthasya kutaha utpattihi kasmad bhavitum arhati na bhavitum arhati. It is not possible that this nitya padartha can be born, says the Ekadeshi Vedanti. Kincha. Further what? Shabdacha. Shabdacha. Ekadeshi Vedanti says, I will also give you Shabda Pramana. Shabdacha. There is also another Shruti. Vayushchantariksham Chaitar Amrutam. Iti Akashe Amruta Shabda Darshanat. Vayushcha Antarikshancha. There is a Shruti like this, which says what? Vayu and Antariksha are what? Amruta. They are immortal, meaning Nitya. Therefore, this Brihat Shruti, which says Vayuhu and Antariksha, meaning Akasha, Vayu and Antariksha are what? Etad Amrutam. Both of these are Amruta, Nitya. Iti Akashe Amruta Shabda Darshanat. Shabdat means Darshanat. There is a Shruti, which is there. Shabda Darshanat. You see this Shruti in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad as to Akasha and Vayu, Antariksha and Vayu are Amruta. Therefore what? Na Akashasya Utpatti Richyartha. Therefore Akasha is definitely not created element. Now the Purvapakshi asks, Nanu ekasmin vakye ekasya sambhuta shabdasya gaunatva mukhyatvancha virujhyate ityata aha. पूर्व पक्षी सेज एकस्मिन् वाक्येन सिंगल वाक्य संभूत शब्दस्य गौणत्व मुख्यत्वञ्च यू आर सेइंग दैट इन द तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद इटसेल्फ व्हाट डू यू हैव और एल्सवेयर आल्सो यू हैव पंचमहाभूतास मेंशन्ड the utpatti of akasha right now and later vayu also that you are saying that is gauna and the utpatti of agni jala and prithvi is mukhya you take taittiriya as an example in taittiriya what do you have the entire vakya is what tasmad vaye tasmad atmanah akasha sambhutah one akashat vayuh two vayor agnih three agne rapah four अद्भ्यक पृथ्वी फाइव सो दीज आर दी फाइव उत्पत्ति इज मेंशन व्हाट आर यू सेइंग यू आर सेइंग आत्मनः आकाश संभूत वन एंड आकाशाद वायुः टू आर गौणी गौणी श्रुति बोथ आर गौण सेकेंडरी एंड मुख्य मीनिंग इज देयर फॉर व्हाट वायोरग्निः अग्नेरापः अद्भ्यक पृथ्वी दी थर्ड फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ उत्पत्ति इज मुख्य सो एकस्मिन् वाक्ये एकस्य संभूत शब्दस्य गौणत्वं मुख्यत्वं च विरुध्यते इत्यतः इन द सिंगल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द श्रुति टू आर गौण एंड थ्री आर मुख्य दैट इज अ विरोध हाउ कैन यू हैव सच काइंड ऑफ अ स्टेटमेंट टू दैट दी एकदेशी वेदांती सेज स्याच्चैकस्य ब्रह्म शब्दवत् स्याच्चैकस्य ब्रह्म शब्दवत् He says like Brahma Shabda. This Brahma Shabda is not in the same meaning everywhere. Brahma Shabda has multiple meanings and in this single section also you can have Ekasmin Prakarne Sambhavati. Vakya is a Prakarna. Meaning Vakya can be treated as a Prakarna. So in a single section you see Brahma Shabda having various meanings. So in Vakya also it is possible. Why is it not possible in the case of संभूत शब्द सो संभूत शब्द कैन हैव मुख्य मीनिंग इन थ्री केसेस एंड इन टू केसेस इट कैन हैव अमुख्य और गौण मीनिंग जस्ट लाइक ब्रह्म शब्द हैविंग मुख्य एज वेल एज एक स्यात् च एकस्य ब्रह्म शब्दवत् सो एक ब्रह्म शब्द वन सिंगल ब्रह्म शब्द कैन हैव मल्टीपल मीनिंग्स शब्दवत एंड लाइक दैट ब्रह्म शब्द सिंगल ब्रह्म शब्द विच कैन हैव मल्टीपल मीनिंग्स इन अ प्रकरण सिमिलरली स्यात् अदर केसेस आल्सो कैन हैव सिमिलर मीनिंग सो एकस्मिन् प्रकरणे मुख्यत्वं गौणत्वं च उभयं स्यात् सेज द एकदेशी दैट इज द वृत्ति हियर स्यात् फॉर स्यात् यू टू से एकस्मिन् प्रकरणे मुख्यत्वं गौणत्वं च उभयं स्यात् एकस्मिन् प्रकरणे एव हाउ सो अन्नं ब्रह्म आनन्दो ब्रह्म इत्यत्र ब्रह्म शब्दवत् अन्नं ब्रह्म इज देयर इन द सेम वाक्य प्रकरण आनन्दः ब्रह्म इज आल्सो आनन्दो ब्रह्म इज आल्सो देयर इन द सेम वाक्य सेम प्रकरण इत्यत्र ब्रह्म शब्द देयर द अन्नं ब्रह्म एंड आनन्दः ब्रह्म अन्नम ब्रह्म इज नॉट लिटरल इट इज गौण एंड आनंद ब्रह्म मीनिंग आनंद ब्रह्म इज नॉट गौण इट इज मुख्य वेन यू लुक एट तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद ऑल्सो व्हाट डू यू सी अन्नमय कोश एंड देन एंडिंग विथ आनंदमय कोश सो अन्नमय कोश एट वन एंड ऑफ द फाइव कोशास एंड आनंदमय कोश एट द अदर एंड So, Ekadeshi Mata we had seen as to Anandamaya Brahma, that Anandamaya Kosha itself is Brahma says the Ekadeshi. And we had seen the refutation through multiple sutras being reinterpreted by the Paramasiddhanti as to Anandamaya is also Kosha, it is not Brahma. But in the Purvapakshi, who is Purvapakshi to Paramasiddhanta, who is Ekadeshi Vedanti. So, the Ekadeshi Vedanti says Ananda Brahma is Mukhya. Because Anandamaya Kosha itself is Brahma, we had seen this. So the same Ekadeshi here is saying, Ekasya Brahma Shabdavat. He is giving this very example as to Anandamaya Kosha is Brahma, there it is Mukhya. Whereas Annamaya Kosha being Brahma, that Vakya is Gauna. There Brahma Shabda is Gauna. एंड इन दी नेक्स्ट केस ऑफ आनंदमय बीइंग ब्रह्म देयर ब्रह्म शब्द इज मुख्य. यथा एकस्मिन्नेव प्रकरणे विषय भेदात अन्नम ब्रह्म इत्यत्र ब्रह्म शब्दो गौणः आनंदो ब्रह्म इत्यत्र मुख्यः. सो नथिंग मोर देयर. पूर्व पक्षी इज बीइंग आंसर्ड बाय एकदेशी वेदांती एज टू अन्नम ब्रह्म शब्द इज गौण एंड आनंदो ब्रह्म देयर ब्रह्म शब्द इज मुख्य. इट इज नॉट लिटरली सो. दिस ब्रह्म इज नॉट लिटरली परब्रह्म परमात्मा. इट इज दिस उपाधि सहित गौण. सो फाइनली एज अन्नमय हैज टू बी सेट असाइड एज दैट ब्रह्म विच हैज गॉट समहाउ गॉट एसोसिएटेड विथ अन्नमय कोश. दैट इज गौण. इट इज नॉट दैट मुख्य परमात्मा हु इज फ्री फ्रॉम एनी कोश. बट आनंद ब्रह्म आनंद इज स्वरूप ऑफ ब्रह्म. देर फॉर आनंदमय कोश इज ब्रह्म. देर दिस ब्रह्म शब्द मीन्स दैट सच्चिद आनंद ब्रह्म. Because Ananda Brahma and Satchidananda, Ananda Shabda is there in the Lakshana Vakya itself. Therefore, their Brahma Shabda is literal. It is the same Paramatma that we have been discussing or as a Tatpare Vishaya throughout Vedanta Veda. Ityatra Mukhya Tatha Prakriti Api. Similarly, in the Srishti Prakriya also, Srishti Prakarana also, Prakriti Api, Vishaya Bheda, in that context of Srishti also, you can take three cases you can take sambhuta shabda as mukhya. In the two cases of akasha and vayu you can take sambhuta shabda as gauna. Why not? Therefore vishe bhedad ekasya gaunatvam mukhyatvam cha syad ityartha. You have to understand the tatparya, and taking tatparya into account you have to say that the akasha and vayu utpatti has sambhuta shabda in the gauna meaning. It is not literally that akasha and vayu have utpatti, but the other three Agni, Jala and Prithvi definitely have Utpatti. Their Sambhuta Shabda can be taken to have Mukhya meaning. Idam Ekadeshi Matam Dushayan Siddhantayati. Now this Parama Siddhanti Vedanti also shows this Ekadeshi Mata is to be taken as a Puropaksha, because there is Dosha in that kind of an interpretation and the Puropakshi should be answered differently. Thereby, the sixth sutra onwards, there is Paramasiddhanta, which is countering Puropakshi as well as this middleman who is Ekadeshi Vedanti. Pratijnyahanir avyatireka chabdebhyaha. Pratijnyahanir avyatireka chabdebhyaha. Pratijnyahani. Avagraha should be read as ahani. Pratijnyahani is what? Pratijnyayaha. Ahani, pratijnya which has been done. What is a pratijnya made? In Chandogya Upanishad, what is a pratijnya? In the sixth chapter. So in the sixth chapter, Chandogya Upanishad has done a pratijnya as to eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam. Ekena jnanena sarva jnanam. By knowing one thing, everything can be known. Because the Pita had asked the Putra, Shvetaketu, has your Acharya in the Gurukula, when he came back home from the Gurukula, with lot of ego, that I have studied all the four Vedas and I am the most brilliant student in the Gurukula. With that kind of an ego and such kind of a fame, which has gotten to him, he came back home, and to break that kind of an asadhu vyavahara or lakshana characteristic of the putra, the pita said, has your acharya taught you that having known which a single thing, everything else can be known as well? Eka vidyanena sarva vidyanam. That kind of a teaching has your acharya given you? So there the putra said no, and then he made some aropa as to they did not know, otherwise how would they have not taught me? All this kind of a trying to get away and still hold on to his ego, he made such kind of a talk, and then the teaching began. So the pratijna is what? Then putra said, pita, you become an acharya, why don't you kindly teach me? I'll become your shishya. एंड देन टीचिंग बिगैन. सो प्रतिज्ञा विच वॉज डन एक विज्ञान सर्व विज्ञान दैट प्रतिज्ञा अहानिहि. अहानिहि मीन्स वॉट दैट वुड नॉट बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज. वेन विल इट नॉट बी कॉम्प्रोमाइज? ओनली वेन आकाश उत्पत्ति इज देर. अदरवाइज इफ आकाश उत्पत्ति एंड वायु उत्पत्ति इज नॉट देर, मीनिंग इट इज गौण, इट इज नॉट मुख्य, देन वॉट कैन यू नो? बाय नोइंग दी परम कारण सर्व कारणानां कारण. वॉट इज दैट कारण विच इज दी मूल कारण फॉर एवरी अदर एवरी थिंग एवरी कार्य एंड एवरी कारण ऑल्सो. दैट वन सिंगल एंटिटी इज ब्रह्मात्मा. Having known Brahmatma, every karya is known. Just like having known Mrit, all the products of Mrit are known. Ghatakumbadi are as well known once you know clay. Similarly, once you know gold, you know every gold karya. Whether it is a bangle, a necklace or a ring, if you ask what is it, they say it is gold. Oh, I know this. So once you know gold, then you know everything that is a product of gold as well. Similarly, knowing the Parama Karana, Prapancha Karana, which is Brahma, which has been established in the Samanvaya Adhyaya, that Brahma being known as Atma, everything else is known because it is Sarva Karananam Karanam, it is the Parama Karana, it is the Karana of all Karanas, which is itself bereft of Karana, Karana Rahita Karana. Therefore, that Pratijna will not be countered only when, will not be compromised only when everything is born of that Brahma. If Akasha is not born from Brahma, then knowing Brahma, Akasha cannot be known. And if Vayu is not born from Brahma, then Vayu cannot be known when Brahma is known. Because Vayu and Akasha will remain separate as not being Brahma Karya, products of Brahma. Says the Siddhanti, therefore, to protect that Pratijna which has been made in the opening statement of the Chandogya Upanishad 6th chapter, you have to say that Akasha and Vayu Utpatti is Mukhya, it is not Gauna. And why else? Vyatireka Shabdacha. Vyatireka Chabdebhyaha. So, Vyatireka Chabdebhyaha. सो आकाशादि सर्वस्य ब्रह्मण व्यतिरेकात्. दैट व्यतिरेकात् इज अ हेतु फॉर प्रतिज्ञा अहानिः. प्रतिज्ञा अहानिः कुतः? व्यतिरेकात् अव्यतिरेकात् सॉरी अव्यतिरेकात् बिकॉज ब्रह्मणः अव्यतिरेकात् नॉट बीइंग सेपरेट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म. आकाश एंड वायु not being separate from Brahma alone will protect the Pratijna made, meaning will not compromise the Pratijna which has been made. Therefore, the Pratijna Ahani is possible only when Akasha and Vayu Utpatti is not Gauna, it is Mukhya. So, Avyatirekat is the Hetu for Pratijnayaha Ahanihi. अव्यतिरेक ब्रह्मण आकाशस्य वायोः च ब्रह्मण अव्यतिरेकात् एव प्रतिज्ञः अहानिः भवति. दैट इज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट वी गेट फ्रॉम द सूत्र. एंड देन व्हाट शब्देभ्यः शब्देभ्यः शब्देभ्यश्च आल्सो ड्यू टू शब्द. व्हाट शब्द? आकाशस्य उत्पत्ति अंगीकर्तव्य. दैट शब्देभ्यः तैतिरीय उपनिषद टॉक्स अबाउट इट. इट इज नॉट गौण श्रुति. In the Chandogya Upanishad, if Akasha and Vayu have not been talked about, still Bhagavan Bhashyakara says the Teja Utpatti is understood from which Brahma? That Brahma which has already taken the form of Vayu, which has been born from that Brahma which has taken the form of Akasha, and which itself is that Akasha itself has been created out of Brahma. Why so? Because Taittiriya Upanishad talks about it. That Taittiriya Upanishad creating Akasha from Brahma and Brahma Rupa Akasha being the source for Vayu, which becomes Brahma Rupa Vayu, meaning Vayu which is the form taken by Brahma, the appearance or the characteristic which are there as upadhi has been taken by the same Brahma. So Brahma, which is Paramatma, appears to be as Akasha, and that Brahma roop or Akasha roop of Brahma is the one which becomes the Karana for Vayu. Then Vayu is what? That Vayu roop of Brahma, which becomes the source for Tejas or Agni to be born. So it becomes the source. And that kind of an understanding should be connected here in Chandogya Upanishad, even if the Utpatti of Akasha and Vayu has not been talked about. Why? Shabdebhyah, Taittiriya Upanishad does talk about it. Elsewhere also, Akasha Utpatti is there, Vayu Utpatti is there. This is the Sutrartha. Upanishadat Brahmana Sarvasya Vastujatasya Avyatirekat. Because of Avyatireka, because everything, what everything, Sarvasya Vastujatasya, Vastu Jata, Samuha, Jata is Samuha, the Vasatiti Vastu, any Vastu that is available for transaction in the Prapancha, starting with Akasha, so Akasha, Vayu, Ityadi as basic elements, and the elementals which are born out of them, whether Sukshma or Stula, the entire Prapancha is the Vastu Jata, Vastu Samuha. So Sarvasya Vastu Jatasya Brahmanaha, which Brahma? From that Brahma, which is Upanishad of Brahma. That Brahma, which is Paramatma, as revealed by the Shruti, by the Upanishad. From that Brahma, the Vastu Jata, Vastu Samuha, all, Sarva, entire Vastu Samuha is born from that, and therefore Avyatirika, being non-different from that, being born is just a Vivarta. It's a Vivrutti, it is not real Parinama, but it is Avyatirika. All the entire Prapancha, starting with Akasha till the end Karya, Sula Prapancha, is all non-different from Parabrahma, because Karya is non-different from Karana. Avyatireka, Eka Vidyana Sarvidyana Pratijnayaha Aha Nirbhavati. Only then, meaning when the Sarva Vastu Jata, meaning Akasha and Vayu inclusive, when all of that is non-different from Brahma, being Karya of Brahma, then alone Eka Vidyana Sarvidyana Pratijnayaha Aha Nirbhavati. Only then will the pratijna of everything will be known as well, when one Brahma Paramakarana is known, Moolakarana is known, that kind of a pratijna will not be counted. Only then, only when Akash and Vayu are also included in this Karya of Brahma. Yadi Akashasya Utpattihi Nasya. But if you do not accept the Utpatti of Akasha, then what will happen? Tarhi sa pratijna hi eta. That pratijna will be compromised. How will you know Akasha having known Brahma, which is not Karana for Akasha, because Akasha is not born? Similarly with Vayu, then Akasha and Vayu at least will not be known by you. Who? What kind of you? That kind of you who has become a Shishya, has done Shravana Mana Nidhyasana, and has known Parabrahma as Karana, which is Atma, for the entire Prapancha. Unfortunately, he will not know Akasha and Vayu. Therefore, this Chandogya, which is saying that everything will be known, this person will not know Akasha and Vayu. What is the point of that Pratijna? That Pratijna hi eta. Ataha tat siddhaye. Therefore, to protect that Pratijna, Pratijna should lead to the end goal. You cannot make one statement. Shruti is what? Shruti is Satyavadi. Shruti cannot be talking some false, making some false statements. Arthavada is different, where there is a particular goal or particular focus to be brought out, and therefore some Arthavada statements are there which are exaggerations. They are not Satyavakyas. Their focus is to their purpose is to bring the Shishya's focus into a particular area which is unknown. And in known areas anyway, Shruti is not Pramana. So Shruti can get away by saying anything and everything as Arthavada, as some kind of a, to bring some kind of a flavor to a particular narration as a story. In stories, everything need not be real. just by creating a story, which imagine this, there are so many novels which are what they are not talking about things which have really happened. They are all stories. So these novels, that's why we say it's a novel idea. It's an idea. So an idea need not be satya, and everyone knows that. So these fictional stories, all these fictions, those who write fictions, they are not, they cannot be considered as asatyavadis. They are not liars. They are telling you that it is a story. They are saying that it is not real. So when you say it is not real and tell something, there is no dosha. It is for entertainment. It is for whatever value there is. So focus is different. So what is the real focus of the Shruti? That is a tatparya vishaya, which is unknown and which cannot be known by any other means. That is the tatparya vishaya. So there the Shruti cannot be lying. So the pratijna which has been made by Shruti is a satya pratijna. And it has to be attained. The goal has to justify the pratijna made. In meetings, we can get away by saying, I'll cover all these topics, so don't worry about it. And then in the end, we can get away by it. At the end, you know, I did not, you know, he said he'll talk about this factor, that factor. None of that has been covered. I was interested in that. I was, you know, I forbore the pain. There was so much of pain to listen to him, but I was waiting for these two topics. They didn't come up. That is possible, but Shruti cannot do that. Therefore, ataha tatsiddhaye, pratijna siddhaye, akashasya utpatti rangi kartavya. You have to accept that even if the Chandogya Shruti does not talk about it, you have to bring it from Taittiriya Upanishad. Kincha shabdebhyaha sadeva somyedamagrasit aitaratmyamidavum sarvam ityadi shabdebhyaha. In Chandogya itself there is shabda as to what? Sadeva somya idamagrasit. Idam, this prapancha. And when you say idam, the objectifiable akasha and objectifiable vayu cannot be outside of idam. So idam sarvam he somya agre srishtehe prak sadeva asit. It was all Sadbrahma itself. So Akasha was Sadbrahma before Srishti and of Prapancha, and Akash Vayu also was Sadbrahma before Srishti of this Prapancha. So Idam includes Akasha and Vayu. That is said to be Sadbrahma. And it can be Sadbrahma before creation only if it is Karya of that very Brahma. Otherwise, you cannot say idam sarvam akasha vayu also is what? Sadeva asit, was sat itself before being manifest. So that Chandogya Shruti also talks about it by saying idam. When you say idam, idam includes all that is objectifiable, and akasha and vayu are also objectifiable. In Vedanta, they are pratyaksha. Aitad atmim idagum sarvam, and idagum sarvam is also there. So idam is qualified by sarvam. All this is what? Aitad atmyam. Aitad atmyam is what? Having idam bhava. Etad bhava. What is that etad? Esha atma. Atma bhava, brahma bhava. Because it has been said, aitad atmyam idam sarvam. Atmyam. Atmana bhava, atmyam. Aitad. So aitad atmyam idam sarvam atmyam is also atma bhava. It is all in Atma Bhava, Atmyam, Ityadi Shabdebhyaha, and all that is in the very same Chandogya Upanishad itself. Therefore, what? Ityadi Shabdebhyaha, Ityadi Shabdebhyaha, Karya Karana Bheda Parebhyaha, Pratijna Siddhir Avagamyate. Avagamyate, it is understood. What is understood? Pratijnayaha Siddhi. The success of the Pratijna which has been made is understood through these kind of shabda statements in the very Chandogya Upanishad, which says what? Which establishes karya karana abheda, which is para, parebhya. These statements are committed to showing abheda between karya and karana. Therefore, atma is karana, and idam sarvam, including akasha and vayu, is what? It is karya. And those Shruti Vakyas which are showing Karana Karya Abheda are also showing Abheda between Karana Atma and what? The Karana Atma, Brahma, Brahmatma, Paramatma, and the karya, which includes in the idam shabda, akash and vayu also. Nacha evam api akashasya utpatto purvokta virodas taravastha evaiti vachyam. And you, the purvapakshi, cannot make a statement or claim that the virodha, which has been pointed out as to akasha not being born at one place and being born at another place, that virodha is not counted at all. This is not a claim that you should be making. Why? So chandogya shrutihi taittiriyaka shrutyanusarena akasham vayuncha srishtva tat tejo srujata iti viparinamyate iti na anayor virodha. So viparinamyate, what the chandogya shruti, which is talking about the tejo srujata, that kind of a manifestation of the agni tejas padartha has been made by the sadbrahma, that statement is in keeping with what akasham vayum cha srushtva, having created an akasha, having created akasha and vayu, then that sadbrahma created tejas iti na anayor virodha. So as per the taittiriya shruti, taittiriya shruti anusarena, in keeping with the taittiriya shruti where akasha and vayu utpatti is mentioned before the srishti of agni ityadi, similarly here those two should be understood. Akasham vayum cha srushtva, having created akasha and vayu, then the sadbrahma created tejas ityadi iti viparinamyate iti na anayor virodha. Therefore there is no virodha between chandogya and taittiriya. It is just that the chandogya shruti does not mention it. Does not mention it does not mean that it is not there. Chandogya shruti does not have a responsibility of mentioning anything and everything just because you want it to. It did not say the akasha is not born. If the statement is akasha is not born, vayu is not born in chandogya, and in taittiriya it is saying akasha is born, vayu is born, then you can say there is virodha and we can think about differently. But just because chandogya does not talk about akasha and vayu srishti does not mean that it is not srishta padartha. Akasha and vayu have been created, chandogya just does not mention it, that's all. Because it is using a different prakriya of three padarthas which are objectifiable with rupa. The prakriya, because in one particular section of the chandogya shashtodhyaya, what the shruti mata does is that it uses this rupa. Rupa is there only in agni, it is not there in vayu and akasha. And since that prakriya is the focus there, meaning a particular methodology has to be used, it is showing a different methodology. There is no panchakosha viveka there in that particular section of Chandogya Upanishad, just like it is in Taittiriya. In Taittiriya, the prakriya which has been used to land on the Atma, Brahmatma, Itya, is panchakosha viveka, where the srishti has been talked about and later followed on. Now this Chandogya sections in the 6th chapter, that section is focusing on a different prakriya where it is saying that look at these rupas, colors that you see in the prapancha. If they are red, then you can think that they are product reddish. If they are reddish in color, then you can think that they are products of agni. If they are whitish in color, you can think that they are products of jala. If they are darkish in color, tending towards black, then you can think that they are the products of prithvi. Therefore, all of these can be resolved into their karana as prithvi or prithvi or jala or agni, tejas. Then you can land on the sukshma agnihi, sukshma jala and sukshma prithvi has been respective karana, and they have been taught as being born from brahma, teja banna, meaning agni, jala and prithvi. Therefore you can resolve all of them directly into brahma. So through three steps, looking at everything in the prapancha which has reddish, whitish or blackish color, into meaning anything close to red, you can put it as reddish. Therefore reddish, anything close to that, orange or something closer. So basically all of that. And then what if you don't see some color which is a, what is green? So if a product appears green, the vriksha is all green, then it is neither red nor white nor black. So some kind of a primary color kind of a thing has been mentioned, where you can imagine that some amsha of this product, some amsha of that product can be mixed together to get a particular green color, just like you do in painting or in video. Whether it is by additive or subtractive methods, there are different primary colors. So just like RGB in additive and in subtractive painting kind of method, it's called subtractive. So there you use different three primary colors. Instead of red, green and blue, they say red, yellow and blue. Those who have painted, they know. And those who have studied video kind of thing, there you have RGB, red, green, blue. So red, green, blue can be primary colors to get all sorts of colors in video. And in basically using light, basically wherever you use light, and wherever you use paper or some canvas and then you draw, there you use red, yellow and blue. So you can get green from red and yellow. Whereas in additive light based primary colors, you can get all colors using RGB. So you can get all colors using RGB and you can get all colors using RYB also. Then why not it be possible to get all colors from using the color of the fire, the color of water and the color of prithvi. So prithvi itself has various shades. So there itself you can get lots of different possibilities of colors. So this is one prakriya, it is a hypothesis. If it appeals to you, you use that process. If it works for you, well and good, you can directly land with a few steps in Karana Brahma. So what is the process there? Look at all the colors as mix of these three basic elements. Then from that you go to their subtle elements. From gross you go to subtle as a second step. And the third step is what they have born from Brahma. Therefore they are not different from Brahma. Therefore the entire prapancha is nothing but the karya of tejaha, jala, up and annam prithivi. And those gross teja, anna and teja, jala and prithvi are born of the sukshma teja, jala and prithvi, agni, jala and prithvi, and they are themselves born from what? The tejo srijata, and then up and then anna, meaning jala and prithvi. So you can land on Brahma as karana. So with three steps you can land on Brahma. In panchakosha viveka you have to do so much. See, is the Chandogya Upanishad, it gives a different methodology. Therefore, Akasham Vayam Cha Srishtvata Tejo Srujata Iti Viparinamate Iti Na Anayor Virodaha Yattu Samagriya Bhavat Iti Tanna. But if you say the Samagri is not available, what about that? Says the Ekadeshi Siddhanti, Ekadeshi Vedanti there. Ekadeshi Vedanti is sitting right there. Purvapakshi has been answered and the answer given by Ekadeshi is not correct. What is the answer given? He says that Samagri is not there. So he says, oh, I have shown that Samagri is not there for Akasha to be born. Samavayi Karana, Asamavayi Karana are absent there. What about that? Ask the Ekadeshi Vedanti, who himself has now become a Purvapakshi. So to answer him, Yattu Samagriya Bhavatiti, Kena Uktam, Ekadeshi Siddhantina, Ekadeshi Vedantina. Tanna, that is not correct. Why? Shrautasya Brahmana Eva Vyat Samagri Itvat. Because what is the Samagri? The Shrauta Brahma, this Brahma who is revealed by the Shruti, that Paramatma himself is Vyat Samagri. He is the Samagri for Akasha. Because if you say Samagri is not there, then we'll ask you for Agni, what is the Samagri? There you'll say, oh, Akasha and Anutpanna, Akasha and Anutpanna, Vayu is the Samagri, is it? What is the Samagri? Brahma is the Samagri. There also, from that kind of Vayu Rupa Brahma, Agni is born, Tejas is born. From that Akasha Rupa Brahma, Vayu is born. Earlier, from that Brahma which is as revealed by the Shruti, Shrauta Brahma, Sat Brahma, Chid Brahma, Ananta Brahma, Ananda Brahma, from that Brahma Paramatma alone this Akasha is born. And then it takes the form of Akasha, becomes the Karana for Vayu. Then it takes the form of Vayu as though and becomes Karana for Tejaha. And this teja also is not teja, it is really sadbrahma, which takes the form of teja, which becomes karana for jala, and so on. This is how the entire prapancha is pervaded by this vyapaka brahma, tattva sachidananda brahma. Wherever you see sat, brahma is exactly there. If you see ghata asti, manushya asti, my enemy is there. My greatest enemy, there also sat brahma is there. So it is all Brahma, Ishavasya Vidam Sarvam. Therefore, what is the Samagri? The same Samagri which is there for any creation. When you create Ghata also, that Mrut which is there is Karana, is not really the Karana. The Karana is Mrudrupa Brahma, which is the Karana, because Parabrahma has pervaded unto this Mrut, including that Mrut, up till and inclusive. Amrut, Asamanta, including that Mrut, Parabrahma has pervaded, and that Parabrahma who is in the form of Mrut is Karana for Ghata. And culturally, if you look at it, every Kulala also will look at this Mrut as Paramatma, meaning it is that which is helping him feed his family, puts the food on table. So all of these, you see, whatever is being used by any of these people to sell or to create something, all of that they see as Bhagavan. They need not be taught Upanishad. They consider all of this as Lakshmi. They'll do Namaskara to it. Before starting, they do Namaskara. You look at any shop also, Hindu shop, you'll see, you know, they'll be worshipping all of that. That is what Ayudh Puja also is. You see, Ayudh Puja, which is done in Navaratri, all that is what basically, Ayudh means weapons. But what are the weapons? We are fighting with all sorts of, you know, with poverty or whatever is opposing. For that, whatever our instruments, they are all our Ayudh. And we do puja so that you know, all those are countered, and that puja we treat them as everything as what, as Bhagavan. Even the there is a in sampradaya culturally, if you buy new clothes also, you wear that and then do namaskara to Bhagavan, because you consider all of this is pervaded by Bhagavan, even not being taught. It is all cultural. So Shrautasya Brahmane Vyat Samagri Tvat, everywhere the Karana, in anything and everything, it is only Bhagavan. Therefore, the Samagri is Bhagavan everywhere, even in the creation of Akasha and Vayu. Similarly, the further refutation of Vayu Utpatti not being there will be considered. Sorry for taking a little much longer today as well, having started late. So let's stop here, continue in the next part. आम्रायन्ते संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंदघरम आपूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे. I had mentioned that if I start another paatha, maybe a few weeks or a month down, then we'll cut down this paatha to 45 minutes. Hopefully 45. Namaste, धन्यवाद.
Sure, namaste. Namaste.